ballin' in that bitch, ballin' in that bitch, ballin' in that bitch, ballin' in that bitch, ballin' in that bitch.
Take young Moose down to go get his vaccinations. We're gonna take Sahara, my pregnant female, down to go get x-rayed and go see how many puppies in her belly and see, you know, make sure her health is up to par. And yeah, man, it's another day of this canine life, man. Y'all, you know, take a ride with us. Yeah, man, so we over here at Abor Pet Clinic. I'm about to go in here and get the Sahara x-ray. She got a big old belly, man, so she's about, I think about 10 days out. So I'm just gonna go check on her, get her checked out. Also, I have Echo, man. He just had a tumor taken off of his toe. So he's gonna get that checked out. And I'm getting some shots for little Moose. So we got a whole little vet visit today, man. So we're gonna go up in here and check out what's going on here in the vet. Echo. So he's just getting his toe checked out. He's okay? Oh, let me go. Okay. Let me see, baby. Put in here. Okay. Looks like we got about 7 to 8 puppies from Sahara. The puppy's doing good. He just got his parvo shot, and now we got to check Echo because he had a tumor that he had to get removed. So we're gonna check that out. Echo! Yeah, man, so Lil Moose got his shots. Sahara got her puppies checked out. Looks like we got a nice little count. Echo got his stitches removed, and he's looking good. Good looking out, Marcos.
See you, all right.
Can't put him on the ground. He doesn't have all those vaccinations. Back up. He got a little pee on there, so let me show you how I multitask. Yeah. You know, this the dog car. A little zoom. So give me where I need to go. So bro, running with Chris, man. I'm gonna have to have you come hit him up a little bit, but for now, we gotta do, man. The Cali canine van. Battery was dead this morning, so Echo, here. When your dogs are socialized, you got that obedience. It's easy to do. May pop them all in the back of the Zoom Zoom. We boom boom. Back up. Today, I just wanted to make sure I go over all the equipment with you guys. So, all of this stuff is ideally, you should have all this stuff as a canine trainer. You see what I mean? At least, you know, this stuff. You know, everybody should have this in their tool bag. At least one dumbbell, you know. And then the neoprene, this is for when you put on the bite suit and the dog don't pinch your skin and stuff. So you don't necessarily need to have this unless you had a bite suit. You definitely want to have at least a harness for your dog, right? You know, so, you know, this right here is like your essential toolkit. Long lines, short lines, pinch collars, flat collars, tugs, something to, you know, retrieval toys, a harness, and again, a means of holding your stuff. So, yeah, that's just a quick little briefing on equipment. So we'll take pictures. I'll make a list of this stuff and make sure that. As far as your toolbox goes, you should have your bag and ready to go with all this stuff. At least one, like I said, just one dumbbell. Or even if it's just a dowel, like even that right there. You see what I'm saying? 15 foot, all your lines, pouches, harnesses, and so on. Make sure you guys have all of this in your kit, you know, anytime, because when you're working with a dog, you gotta be able to say, okay, I need this, I need that. You're gonna need all of this stuff. You know what I mean? Small dog, you gotta check and see his prey drive with the small tug. You see what I mean? With the big dog, same thing, you gotta have a bigger tug. Sometimes your dog might be wanting to get into working dog protection shit. Now we gotta bring in the tug. Kira, she took this one. Kira, Bring.
Good. Good.
Out. Good. So touch for you.
Good.
So this right here is like a prerequisite. Like this is what you build. So you want to have a long. You might have not a whole bite sleeve, but you can build all of the prey drive work and all the prey cycle work on the tie back with this. You see what I'm saying? So you can get all your protection done by yourself. And then when the decoy comes in, you work on specifics, things for the routine or whatever scenario you're working on. But for the most part, you can do a lot of your training, all of our basic behaviors. So we have, our place, our sit down stand, our come, our heel, our touch, our search, all this stuff, right? But then you have the prey drive, which is the bark, the bite, the pull, the hold, the carry, the out. Right, and all that can be done on a tie back. So if you can essentially train your dog for 16 to 20 behaviors on your own with no decoy. See what I mean? So as trainers and your dog, it's like what five behaviors you gonna work on today? What by five behaviors you gonna work on tomorrow? How can you pair five and then five, and you know what I'm saying? So you're getting all 20 of these behaviors taught, proof, and secure. You see what I mean? So then by the time you come to the decoy shit, all you need is 5 minutes. All right, go ahead and do this little thing, and now you're done. You don't need someone to build your dog up. You built your own dog.
Ballin' in that bitch.